This week is New Zealand Sign Language Week, so good morning. This is a fantastic week to just bring some exposure to the fact that sign language is New Zealand's as an official language. And of course, during the earthquake coverage on the television, we had the opportunity of seeing lots of sign language in action, which was fantastic to see, and even at the Christchurch Memorial Service as well. So if you get a chance, have a look at the internet, see if you can find some sign language, or do what I'm doing and take a class. Well, we're back in Parliament after a two-week recess, so the end of the school holidays. We had ANZAC Day. I was at the Dawn Service in Turangi and at the Civic Service in Taupo. Huge attendances, and I think what we're seeing every year, despite the horrendous weather, increasing crowds, just taking a moment to remember those that have been lost in past battles and who are currently serving in New Zealand forces overseas. Last week I was fortunate to have the Minister of Conservation, Kate Wilkinson, visit Mangatauturi with me. And it was a great opportunity to get up close to a Kiwi. Very exciting. It was the first time I've been that close. And the Minister was really thrilled to see the community project in action. And I think the clear message was that the community really embraces this project. It's important that it succeeds. And so we're working through some of the current challenges with the parties involved. Also last week in Taupo, I was at the launch of the Business Excellence Awards. Fantastic turnout of people there, so I think that there will be a large number of applicants for those awards. I was previously a Business Excellence Evaluator before I came to Parliament, and I know how important it is for people to put their businesses up under the spotlight, have another set of eyes, have a look at it, and that's the way that you get to have really good feedback about what you can do to improve your business. Start of the recess, I was also involved in a tree planting at the Cambridge Tree Trust, and that's down on the banks of the Waikato River, not far from the, actually behind the library building. They've done a lot of work around the walkway down there, and it was great to see that the Tree Trust won an award, a Supreme Award, in the Waipa Awards just this week, so that's very exciting and well done. One of the things that I'm really proud of in terms of being part of the national government is the work that we've done around supporting victims. And if we think back over time, there's been a lot of criticism about criminals and all the support they get. Well, we're actually putting the weight back in favour of the victims and putting mechanisms in place. The victims' centre, the victims' code, I think it's called, and a levy charging offenders, a $50 levy that go to support services for victims, because it's a very complex judicial system. So if somebody has to go to court and testify, give a victim impact statement, it actually takes a lot of time and energy and money and resources to do that, and we're now supporting the victims in navigating that process, because at the end of the day they are the innocent party who, by circumstances, being in the wrong place at the wrong time, has been on the receiving end of what many of us know are some nasty crimes. So we're putting the balance back in their favour and supporting them through the process in a range of different mechanisms. And I've got information on the website in more detail about the proposals that are coming up for reform and also the things we've already done. So thanks for joining me today, and I look forward to catching up again next week.